this up, right? So Microsoft Fabric is a complete data platform for building analytics solution in this era of AI. It has two different components. The one leg is basically the data virtualization layer sitting on all your data across enterprises, whether it's coming from lake houses in Fabric or data lake storage account or Amazon S3. It's all single source for your data throughout your organization. And then it sits on the different computing engine, or basically based on breed computing engine that provides the performance that you expect. At the same time, it's based on serverless architecture. So you pay for only the uses that you are going to use that compute engines for. The best part is they are all natively integrated. So you don't have to worry about integrating those different pieces together. And as I gave an example earlier, if you use one engine to create a table, the table is going to be visible across all the engines, and you can query the table from the other engines. And the example was about creating a pipeline to create a table while landing the data from the source. To be accessible in a Spark or data warehouse with SQL, or even in Power BI to do reporting on top of that. As of now, we have Microsoft Fabric in public preview. All these core capabilities related to data fabric, data engineering, data science, data warehousing, these are all available in public preview for you to get started. To get started, you can go and try out the first link that I have listed down here. I'm going to paste this in the chat window. So go to aka.ms/try-fabric. This is where you can get started with trial edition, and that will allow you to kind of work with Fabric for next couple of months or until GA time. We have official documentation about Fabric, fabric.docs, which talks about in general what a Fabric feature is, but we have another documentation which talks about end-to-end scenario. That's a third link, right? So basically the idea here is when we talk about building analytics solution, whether we are talking about lake house or warehouse or real-time analytics or data science solution, we have created this scenario-based end-to-end tutorial where you can complete this tutorial in 30 minutes to 1 hour time, right? You can build this whole end-to-end POC or solution from start to end in like roughly 30 minutes to 60 minutes time. So this whole end-to-end tutorial will guide you through whole of the experience of Microsoft Fabric. The last link is about submitting any idea. So we are very open for learning from what you need. So Microsoft Fabric ideas is the link where you can go and submit any idea that you think is not available currently, or any feature request that you have. You can go and search for people kind of asking for those features. You can vote for those features, or you can submit a new feature request if you don't find it there. So with that, thank you so much for joining this meeting. I know it's a Sunday evening in India and morning time in US. Again, thank you so much for joining at this time. With that, we can open up for question if anyone has any question.
Yeah, so one question is from myself. Hi, Arashad, this is Anjani. If you can hear me.
Yeah.
So the way you example there at it's the Power BI was directly getting empowered from, you know, Parquet file.
Right.
So if I have a delta table somewhere, right? Maybe in the Azure Data Lake Storage Gen 2, I have generated it through Databricks or anything. Can that be directly used in the Power BI through one data lake?
Yes, it can be. So the idea here is not to let you kind of copy data from one storage account to a storage account. So for example, you are currently using Databricks and you have your data lake created into ADLS Gen 2 account. So you come to Fabric, create a shortcut to your storage account, and once the shortcut is created, the table will be visible in Power BI to create a report on top of that. So yes, you will. You don't need to kind of copy the data. The data is going to be accessible from the Power BI.
There are a couple of other issues. Many of our organizations, what they have done is they have Synapse data in Synapse. They process data in Synapse. Then we have SQL Server Analysis Services. Few of our organizations who are, you know, who have been searched by multiple enterprise team across the globe, to do like that. So the purpose was that because the data is so much that they cannot, you know, import all the data to their Power BI and they can run all the, you know, report seamlessly. So they create their model SSAS, the SSAS online, and then they expose it to, you know, Power BI. That has a lot of issues also, because when the model get created, if they have to expand that model, they have different challenges, right? The UI also get changes. So if we have to do everything through a delta table, the set of delta table where we define our fact and dimension, is that possible now?
Yes.
Because Power BI, when it's a real-time data, it's the it always gives problem in creating extra columns, or maybe, you know, measures, or even the relationship. And then the another problem is, like, if you bring the data into Power BI, and let's say you want to use it into Power Platform, let's say Power App is, you are integrating Power BI with the Power App, there are a couple of challenges that come. So are those challenges being catered now, and will that be, you know, handled with this, you know,
yes, platform? Yes. So that has been a pain for a very long time. We have been hearing that complaint for a very long time. And the idea here is to take care of those challenges platform itself. So you are right. You don't have to replicate the data into different storage account. You don't have to copy data from one place to other place to make it kind of work. And data can still be on the lakehouse in open lake format, or basically delta lake format. But at the same time, you can create a semantic model. In the UI, if you remember from the demo, there was a diagram view of the different tables. You can kind of set up the relationship, you can create measures, you can create DAX expression and all those things. So having said that, it's not going to replicate your data. It's just a kind of creating a semantic model on the data which is sitting into Lakehouse. And it's just one copy of the data. So we are no longer requiring you to kind of maintain multiple copy of the data. It's just one copy of the data. And one of the capabilities that Microsoft has for a very long time is what natively being built into the platform itself. So it's called, so when you use any engine in Fabric to write a delta table, the file gets or one of the feature that we are using, it is called vertiparchy, or basically the reordering of the file. So basically we arrange or sort the data in a way that it's more compressed, or the size of the compressed file is much, much smaller than what you see with the regular Parquet file. But at the same time, we are keeping it open so that, like, once the file gets created or delta table gets created. So basically, if you have a data set, you're using any of the engine in Fabric, the delta file gets created, or the Parquet file gets created. The size of the Parquet file is going to be much, much smaller because of the native feature that we are using in Fabric. But at the same time, we have kept it open. So you can take that file or delta table and use it in